This is part 2 of a multi-part series, and I recommend that you watch the previous edition before watching this one. After defeating Vader at the Sith Temple in Malachor, Ahsoka Tano found her way to the World Between Worlds thanks to Ezra Bridger, who escorted her to a galaxy that is in dire need of liberation. Young Bridger presented to Ahsoka someone who he had found an ally in, but Tano was in no rush to trust the individual. It was Maul that stood before her, and she needed no reintroduction to the former Sith. The two had dueled years earlier on Mandalore, and Tano was the victor, but things were very much different back then. Now the Empire reigned supreme, and the Rebellion was running to every corner of the galaxy, which only made her wonder how Maul made his way here. Her thoughts were to herself, but it didn't take long for her expression to reveal how she felt about it all. Maul then took the time to explain what was happening.
When you killed Vader, the Empire scrambled. They ended the Senate, shut down planets, and executed traitors. Amongst the chaos, I retreated back to my home on Dathomir, but I realized their greatest weakness. Their leader, my former master, has no clear apprentice, which may very well leave him vulnerable.
Ahsoka protested the thought, telling Maul that there had to be another apprentice for Palpatine to choose from. Palpatine would always be prepared for something like this. Maul turned to Tano with a smile, almost as though he expected for her to have that response.
You would expect so, but he shut all possibilities out. His Inquisitors are far too weak to be an apprentice, especially if that to the level of Vader. He has nothing but himself, making him a target that we must strike.
Ezra then approached Tano, putting a hand on her shoulder. He told the former Jedi that he knew the idea was crazy, but it was all they had. He then explained to her that they had learned that Palpatine would be attending an Empire Day celebration that was to be held on Lothal. Tano found that to be strange. She asked why would Palpatine even consider setting foot on Lothal, to which Maul was more than willing to offer an explanation.
It's not the Empire Day that brings our fair Emperor to Lothal. It is this temple that he's interested in. It holds a power that he wishes to control, and you just witnessed such power.
Ahsoka was quick to realize that the World Between Worlds was what Palpatine saw the most interest in, but still had her reserves. If the Empire was coming to Lothal, they would need a massive force, and from the sounds of it, what the Rebellion had was dwindling. Ezra explained that even though they were being pushed back, some important leaders were still alive. Admiral Ackbar and his fleet were still lurking in the galaxy, and Mon Mothma and the troops she commanded had also found refuge on a backwater world not too far from Lothal. They were all sending what support they could in order to strike the Empire at its heart. Maul then stepped towards Ahsoka, his red eyes piercing the darkness.
You've killed the apprentice, Lady Tano. It is now time to do the same for the Master.
As Maul exited the temple, Ezra was quick to reaffirm that Ahsoka could trust the former Sith. They all had the same goal right now, and they needed cooperation for the plan to work. The trio left the temple and made way for the secluded location in the mountains of Lothal, where Rex and Hera had made camp. The astromech droid that the Ghost crew called Chopper was tampering with the holonet device when Maul, Ezra, and Ahsoka approached. Ahsoka immediately found comfort in Rex, who hadn't seen her since she left for Malachor. When asked what was happening, Rex informed her they were about to receive a transmission from Mon Mothma about the upcoming mission. Just as Rex finished his explanation, the sound of a hologram flickering filled the air as Mon Mothma appeared. She explained to the Ghost crew the extent of the mission. Rebel soldiers will be sent down hours before the arrival of Palpatine, and once Admiral Ackbar makes contact with the Imperial fleet stationed above, that will be a signal for the ground team to begin the assault. Harrison Dula passed on warning for the space fleet, informing Mothma that Imperial chatter shows that Grand Admiral Thrawn has been assigned as an escort for the Emperor. Mothma responded that she expected such a move, but had faith in Ackbar that he could stave off his Chiss counterpart. As Mon Mothma prepared to end the transmission, she found the time to welcome Ahsoka back to the effort and hope that she would be a deciding factor in the upcoming battle. As the hologram dissipated, Maul chimed in with his plans.
It will be my mission to confront the Emperor, but now that we have Lady Tano, it appears that I won't have to do that on my own.
Ahsoka didn't know what to say, but nodded her head. She knew there was no other option at this point. Lothal was said to be one of the most important battlegrounds in the midst of the Galactic Civil War. This was part 2 of What If Ahsoka Tano Killed Darth Vader. Stay tuned as part 3 will be coming soon. Feel free to check out other What If series for the channel by clicking on the corresponding link in the description below. And if you have any suggestions for a series, put them in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button and share with your friends. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the Marauders Guild and ring the bell to be notified about whenever we upload. Until the next time, may the force of others be with you.